Hola.
I am back.
In a different part of the hotel room. If you don't know what I'm talking about, the video before this, I filmed in, like, the bathtub or something. Something clever like that. I decided to make a video on long-distance relationships. I've done one before. I don't know. At this point, I might have erased it and whatnot, but I wanted to make a better one because there's a lot of us that just have questions as to, do you think it's going to work out? I've been in one before, and it's really hard. It's really, really hard. Not gonna sugarcoat it at all. I'm just gonna give it to you straightforward. It's really hard because there's always trust issues. There's always thoughts that go through your mind. Like, I don't know what they're doing right now. They don't know what I'm doing right now. They could be, like, with somebody else hooking up, and I won't even know. We need to be positive and focus on the good things. I just think that if you can't trust a person like that, and they give you reasons enough to not trust them, and it's just something about them, and you know for a fact that you can't really trust them like that, then don't be in a relationship because you're just wasting your time. Something's telling you that. Unless you're like an overly jealous person, you gotta either control your jealousy or just don't be in it. Don't put someone through that because it really does suck. You don't know what kind of harm you may be doing to them. So I would say you have to trust that person. And I think one of the big things is a lot of communication. Also making time for them. There's Skype, instant messaging. I don't know if you guys really do that anymore, but there's emails, phone calls. You just got to keep in mind that there's always going to be that one thing, which is the miles between you two. And the fact that you can't be there in their moments when something special is going on with them, and you can't be there, or they can't be out with your friends, and all of that will get to you eventually. I think that the power of love is way, it beats it, it defeats it. If you guys are in one right now, and there's problems, talk about it. If something's bugging you on that end, tell them, and fix it, and tell them how you feel. Tell them how that situation makes you feel, and how you wish it could be, but be nice about it. Don't be all rude. Don't get mad about it. Don't make them feel like shit. Just talk to them about what's going on. Make sure that you guys don't ever go to bed being mad at each other, because that's just one of the worst things you can do. A lot of people have commitment issues, and if you have commitment issues, don't get into a long-distance relationship, because if the other person is sincere and really wants to try things with you, don't get into a relationship, because that's just gonna fuck them up. They just don't need to be played like that. Don't get someone's hopes up if you can't even settle down for yourself and be able to be committed to them, because that's what a relationship is, right? You got commitment. You've got respect, and you've got communication, and trust, and honesty, and protection, and all that. So, essentially, what everybody's trying to do is protect their heart, for the most part. Because I know it's always like this and that, but for the most part, everybody's trying to protect their heart. So, why don't you do yourself a favor, and don't mess up anybody else's heart, and break their heart when you know that it's not going to work out. That simple. I do believe that long-distance relationships work. There's a Spanish saying that says, amor de lejos, amor de pendejos, which is pretty much, long-distance relationship is pretty much for dumbasses. I mean, I didn't translate that right. I don't know. Don't pay attention to my translation, but it's something along those lines. I don't know. I never used to believe in it, and I think that love just comes from behind and bites you in the ass, and you won't even know. Sometimes it's unexpected, and you never know when it's going to hit you. That's the beauty of love. It can travel so far from here. You can be in New York, somebody else in California, and they just, it's the connection. You can't help who you fall for. Your heart has no eyes. It's not going to be like, oh, look, there's a man with a beard. I love his beard. I'm going to fall for him because he has a beard. It just doesn't work that way. Did that make sense? Maybe not. I don't know. It made sense in my brain. Another cute thing that I really, really like is that you can send each other stuff. Like, send them snail mail or send them a surprise in the mail. They won't know. Just send them something that reminds you of them. You can send them flowers. You can do all this stuff in the meantime until you get to see them and be with them. The cool thing about long-distance relationships is that you both learn how to appreciate each other when the time comes down to, like, hanging out. I feel like a lot of people take a lot of things for granted. One of the things is them being with each other and having the time that they spend with each other. Being in a long-distance relationship really gives you the whole perspective on how it is to be away from the one person that you really want to be with. It's really a way to see how much you really do appreciate things, and hopefully you guys appreciate each other. Long distance relationships do work, and they're possible. It's just people that haven't had things happen like that. It'll definitely work out, though. I'm not the best at answering questions. I'll give you that right now, but I'll give you what I know, and I'll tell you what I think or whatnot, but feel free to ask me. You follow my Tumblr. Everything's blue. I hope you guys have a great whatever day it is. And I'll see you super later. And yeah. All right. See ya.